All right. Let's say hello to our first guest, Laura Anthony from Legal and Compliance, LLC. How are you, Laura?
I'm fantastic. How are you today?
Oh, it's good. Thank you so much for being with us this week.
Thank you for having me.
So, Laura, tell me, what does Legal and Compliance, LLC, what is your specialty?
We are a full-service corporate securities and business transactions law firm. So we do represent a lot of companies that are public. We represent over 55 public companies, and we do all of their work, their filings with the SEC. Some of them report alternatively with OTC markets. We do those reports. We do their M&A transactions, their officer and director filings with the SEC, and any other secure transactional and corporate work they need. We also represent twice that number of private companies. So any private company work, again, business transactions, corporate finance transactions, M&A. We do a lot of private offerings. We do a lot of public offerings. So it could be a going public transaction. We do a lot of IPO work. It could be reverse mergers for going public transactions. We do a lot of Regulation A work. We have 17 Regulation A offerings in progress right now.
Wow.
And we also represent, one attorney here does nothing but represent on the investor side. So we represent small hedge funds, family offices, investor groups. But we really are full service. We have 10 attorneys here, and if you're in the small or middle market, we can help you out.
Golly, it sounded, now, ladies and gentlemen, that wasn't a commercial. Although you were very good, you could be a spokesman for your own company. So you're the perfect spokesman.
I have practice.
There we go. You guys are deep, obviously deep into businesses and helping them figure the path out, the best path to go. Let me ask you a question. So if I'm a private company, when do I know, when is it time, do I make that step? I need money. I'm trying to grow. I'm trying to acquire companies. When is it time to make that step to a Reg A or doing a regular public offering?
Well, a lot of companies, I believe, go public prematurely, a little too early. And the reason that they do is because it's very difficult to access private capital. The bigger companies, the tech companies that have a CEO that's had two amazing exits in the past, those companies find it very easy to raise private capital. But your regular small businesses that are on a growth trajectory have a very hard time raising private capital, and so a lot of times they go public a little too soon. But I can understand why, and we can actually help them if that's the route they need to go. But you don't have to always access public markets. I think that, first of all, when you're ready to raise money and you're ready to talk to investors, the first thing that you should do is do an internal audit of your own business. Get your ducks in a row. Get your house clean. Make sure all of your corporate records are complete. Make sure they're organized. Make sure that you have a investor-facing PowerPoint presentation, that you have completed bios of your officers and directors, that you have historical financial statements that have been prepared in accordance with U.S. GAAP, and that you have projections that make sense. Sometimes I see people that they'll talk about a market. They'll say, look, the market for this is $2 billion. But what they don't do is talk about the addressable market. What realistically can that business capture of this entire market, and what is the plan for them to capture it? So the first thing to do is to make sure you have your own house in order so that when you talk to an investor, they see that you're organized, they see that you have a reasonable, ascertainable business plan, right, and business model.
Yeah.
Once you do all of that, then you will engage in one or two rounds of private financing. Now, the Jobs Act, in addition to creating the wonderful Reg A, which I am a huge advocate for, also created 506C and Title III crowdfunding. These are two other methods to raise money privately that allow you to engage in general solicitation and advertising. So I usually recommend that a company that can't otherwise raise funds privately utilize one or two of these other methods to raise funds privately, move their business along a little more, right? It's nice if you have revenue, if you've met some milestones. Let's talk about meeting milestones.
Hold on, Laura, and I'm just have to slow you down 1 second, but because you're You're on a great path, but we have to take a break, and we're going to be right back with CEO Money and Laura Anthony, and she's on the fast track to tell us exactly how to straighten our company out if we're looking for an exit clause or raising money. So we'll be right back with CEO Money. All right. Welcome back to CEO Money. I'm here with Laura Anthony, and she's schooling us on what to do with your business, either if you want to take it public, stay private, how you set your business up, make sure. You know, you should, Laura, I think, have your stuff and all your ducks in a row anyway. It would make for a smarter company, wouldn't it?
Absolutely. And as I was thinking while we were on break, that's exactly what I was going to say next, is that any company, if you intend to grow and access investor money and ultimately to go public, you should act as if you are public and responsible right from day one. You should make sure your books and records are maintained properly, make sure your corporate records are maintained properly, follow your articles and bylaws, and make sure that you have decent articles and bylaws. If you're an LLC, make sure that you have a good operating agreement and follow the provisions. So take care of your corporate governance from the beginning.
Sure.
And show that you have strong management and officer and director skills. And that will pay off, and it will resonate with the customers and the people that you do business with.
Now, it sounds like you've seen about every scenario. So
I have.
Say my company is doing $9 million a year. I see a potential upside. I think I could push this thing to 20, maybe acquire a couple more people. Not quite sure what I should do. How do I make that decision? Is it to go public? Is it an exit strategy, or is it really to grow it strategy?
At a $9 million a year business, it's not an exit strategy. If you're a $9 million business, then I would suggest, if you're looking to exit, that you look to just sell your company, whether you sell it to a public company or a private company. But I wouldn't use that. Investors are not going to be interested in putting money into a $9 million company just to pay out to existing shareholders. They're going to want to see their money go to the highest and best use, and that highest and best use for them will be growth. But at $9 million, you are, depending on whether or not you're profitable, and whether or not you're profitable compared to other companies in the same industry.
Sure.
And the ability of your management team. But at $9 million, if you've met your milestones, you've been on some steady growth, you see that you can get yourself to $20 million in a relatively short period of time with some infusion of capital and some acquisitions, you actually are in a very nice position to utilize Reg A as a going public transaction. And you can go public either onto OTC markets. The OTCQX level of OTC markets is very respectable. Or to go public onto the NASDAQ small cap or the NYSE American. And I think in that scenario, what you've just talked about, I'm at $9 million and I see the trajectory to $20 million. You are a very interesting company to go public utilizing Regulation A or even S-1, but really Regulation A.
So I've got 60 seconds. Let me know. Tell me about just a quick brief overview of Reg A and what is it for the positive side? We spoke a lot about it. What is it positive? How does it affect the investor?
Well, from the positive side, it's just another process to go public, but it has many benefits than the regular process. One, you can engage in solicitation and test the waters, and you can communicate with the public and get people interested in your offering before you actually launch. And then even when you launch, you can use social media and other aspects to encourage people to invest in your offering. So you have an advertising and solicitation and marketing ability that you don't have in regular offerings.
Laura.
Two, it preempts state law, blue sky law, which saves you a lot of time and expense. And three, the SEC review process is a little lighter than a regular IPO process, again, saving time and expense.
You're a powerhouse in this arena. Tell us how people can reach you.
www.legalandcompliance.com or 561-514-0936.
Very good.
My email is lanthony, my first initial and full last name, at legalandcompliance.com.
Laura Anthony, thank you for being on CEO Money. Till next time, I appreciate it.